Assalamu alaikum class, this is our third lecture, online lecture. I hope you have enjoyed it so far. So if any difficulty, we will have online session and we can discuss it that. You can make note of the of any questions if you have with the slide number and then we can go over it again. So today, last time we had done multi-pressure system, we have discussed it, how the system works. What are the components, what are the energy balance equation, etc. So today I'm going to solve some numerical for the multi-pressure system. The first one is for a system which has two evaporator in it and one compressor. So this one is two evaporator and one compressor. This is the energy balance that we had done last time for two evaporator with single compressor. Two evaporator with single compressor. So this one is utilizing a pressure reducing device and we have to do an energy balance or enthalpy balance after PRV or inlet of the compressor at point one. We have to do that. And this is the mass balance at this point here between 6 and 1. So the example is a two evaporator and one compressor refrigeration system uses R134 as working fluid. So our working fluid is R134. This is the pH diagram for that. The system operates evaporator 1 at 0 degree centigrade. Evaporator 1, this one at 0 degree centigrade. This temperature here is wrong. Currently make a note of that. This is 0 degree centigrade. Evaporator 2 at minus 26.4 degrees centigrade, and this is evaporator number 2 and this is at minus 26.4 degrees centigrade. That's about the right. So lower one should be the minus 26 and the above one should be 0 degrees centigrade. So this one must be minus 26 degrees centigrade and this one must be 0 degrees centigrade. Two evaporators and the condenser at 800 kilopascal. So this line is 800 kilopascal. The refrigerant is circulated through the compressor at the rate of 0.1 kilogram per second. So m dot is given as 0.1 kilogram per second through the compressor at the rate of this. So the mass flow rate from this compressor is 0.1 kilogram per second. And the low temperature evaporator serves a cooling load of 8 kilowatts. So this one, the low temperature one, must be the bottom one, has a cooling capacity of 8 kilowatts. Determine the cooling rate of the high temperature evaporator, the power required by the compressor and the COP of the system. The refrigerant is saturated liquid at the exit of the condenser. So here it is a saturated liquid, not subcooled. It's a saturated liquid. And this, the condenser and saturated vapor at the exit of the heat evaporator and the compression is isentropic. The compression process is isentropic. So let's go over. The first thing we have to do is to find out enthalpies at major points, especially at the saturation lines, at the saturated liquid line and saturated vapor line, and then we have to find out the superheated enthalpy of state 2. So m dot 1 is given at 0.1 kilogram per second and Q dot L1, that is the evaporator 1, is 8 kilowatt. Cooling capacity of the refrigerating capacity of the low temperature evaporator is 8 kilowatt. If these two information is given, then H4 and H3 are equal. In fact, H4, H3 are equal. And H4, H3 and H7, they're all equal here. H3, H4, H7, they're all equal. And H5 is 8G at 0 degree centigrade. H5 is 8G at 0 degree, this is 0 degree temperature here. So 0 degree centigrade. So if we look it up, 0 degree centigrade, 8G value is 398.60, so that's what here. H8 is 8G at minus 26.4 degrees centigrade. H8 is this point here, which is HG at minus 26.4 degrees centigrade, the lower evaporator temperature. So that is 382.57. If we look up, we don't have 26.4, we have 26 and we have oil at 27. So you have to do an interpolation for that. If you look it up, the value for minus 26 degrees centigrade, then 8G for minus 26 is 382.82, and this is 382.57. So we need to do probably an interpolation here, and we'll get this value. So we did find out the enthalpies at the major points. Now H3 is HF at 0.8 megapascal. 800 megapascal is the pressure of the condenser, so 0.8 megapascal. It will be from H3 will be saturation table. Saturation table at 0.8 megapascal. So we don't have 0.8 exactly. We have 0.814 megapascal. So again, the value here is 244.62, and I have taken 243.58. So we will have to go through an interpolation process, then we will get this answer of 243 instead of 244. Okay. So that will be the H3 here. Then H3 is equal to H4 and H7. So QL1 is equal to M dot 8 multiplied by H8 minus H7. So this way we can find out what is the mass flow rate in the low temperature, the lowest temperature evaporator, because these two values are from the table, the two are up. We find that out earlier. So this one is 0.0576 kilograms per second. Okay. I hope you understand. H7 is H3. H3 is right there. And H8 is 8G at minus 26.4. So this is there, 382.57. Replace the values here. Q dot L1 is given. So we can figure out M dot 8 is constant. Now, do the energy balance. I got the point there, after point, this point here, this point here. So M8 plus M6 should be equal to M1. M8 plus M dot 8 plus M dot 6 should be equal to M dot 1. So because we figure out what is M dot 8 is, and M dot 1 is given, so M dot 6, which is the mass which is going through the high temperature evaporator, which is 0.0424. Okay. M.6 and M.5 are same before, and M.6 and M.5 they are same because they are just before the pressure reducing valve. Energy balance at state 1. Okay. So H8 is the energy which is flowing in, and M.6 and H6 are also flowing in at this point here. 6 and 8 are flowing in, 1 is flowing out, should be equal to M.1 H1. So from here we can accurately pinpoint what is the value of H1. Okay, H1 here, it seems that it is on the saturation line, but it will be a little bit off. So the value of H1 turns out to be 389.37. Okay, now as we know H1, and we know P1 is Psat at minus 26.4 degrees centigrade, which is 0.1 megapascal. We use the pH chart to locate state 1 using H1 and P1 and find S1 is equal to 1.77. So using the pH chart here, we can find out S1. So S1 will be 389 right here. I wrote down the 389 value here, and this is the pressure line, 0.1 pressure line. So we have to figure out how much value is this one, the entropy value here. That will be S1. So it is between 1.7 and 1.8. If you can see, 1.7 and 1.8. So we have taken it as 1.77. All right. For isentropic compression, S2 is equal to S1, S2 is equal to S1, and V2 is equal to 0.8, which is the condenser pressure. So from the superheated table at 0.8 megawatt, megapascal, sorry, we find H2 as 433. So if you can see it, 0.8 in superheated table, I have copied it here. Add the two values of S1 is equal to S2, which is 1.77. Not in the table, we have 1.7758 or 1.74. Okay, and the P pressure value is 0.8 is there. So I can take 0.8 is there in the separated table. So, but the entropy, the exact entropy is not there. So we can take an interpolation. We are discussing for point two how to find out the enthalpy value for point two. So for that, what we know is what is the entropy value at point one. So point one entropy value can be found out from the table, as we know this pressure, the evaporator one pressure, which is a saturation pressure at -26.4 degree, which is 0.1 megapascal. So 0.1 megapascal, this pressure line and enthalpy of 389 will determine what is the S1 value, and then this S1 should be equal to the value of entropy at point S2. So the S1 value we determine from the chart using H1 and the pressure of 1 megapascal. So here you go, look at this one here. So this is the 389 enthalpy value of H1 that we have calculated, and this is the pressure of 0.1 megapascal, which is the evaporator pressure. So these two lines are crossing here, and these are the constant entropy line which are passing, 1.7 and 1.8. so the blue line is our target line. So if we estimate, it will be more than 1.7, less than 1.8. it is more close to 1.8. so we consider it to be a 1.77 entropy. Now this entropy and the entropy value at the condenser inlet should be same. So this is the compressor inlet, this is the compressor outlet, which is going into the condenser inlet. Condenser pressure is 800 kilopascal or 0.8. so this red line is the condenser pressure line. So this constant entropy line is causing it at this point. We draw a straight vertical line from here. The yellow one is the enthalpy, will give you the enthalpy value at point two. So H2 is about 433 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin. So that will be the H2 value. So we can find out H2 value by the table. As it says here, alternately draw a constant entropy line from 1 and a state 2 lies where it intersects the 0.8 megapascal line. Read the H2 value from the chart. Okay, so we can do that way, or we can do the interpolation here with the superheated table of 0.8 megapascal. So if you look up superheated table, 0.8 megapascal and entropy of 1.77, so 1.77 is straightforward, is not there. So we interpolate between this is showing the values of enthalpy and entropy for 0.8 megapascal superheated R134 vapor. So if we interpolate 424.61 and 434.85, we'll get about this 433 kilojoule per kilogram value. So that's how we determine H2. Now with the help of this H2, we can find out the compressor work. And in the meanwhile, we can also calculate what is the cooling capacity of the second evaporator, the evaporator at the top here, because we know H4 and H5 already. We have determined that value, H4 and H5. H5 was, where is H5 here? Let's see, H4 and H5. H4 is actually equal to H3, and H5 is Hg at 398. So those are the two values. We can use those values. That will give us the cooling capacity of the high temperature evaporator, which is 6.573 kilowatt. And because we already determined what is the H2 value, H1 we already know, so we can calculate what is the compressor work required, mass flow rate was given, so compressor work is 4.363 kilowatt. Now we can use both evaporator cooling capacity divided by the total compressor work, that will be the COPR. That value is 3.34, sorry, that is the COPR for this multi-pressure refrigerating system. So I hope you understand. If there is any question, any queries that you have, you can ask during the live session. Should make a slide number and the question, then you know I should be able to answer you. But have your tables and annexure that we have supplied you handy with you, printed and handy with you. So when we refer to a value, we can look up the table and can find out. You should look up all these values already from your table. The values that I have copied here, I just copied for my quick reference, but you have to know it how to do it. And plus you have to already practice this thing, how to draw these lines, the constant pressure lines and the constant entropy lines, and how to get the read the value from the chart. So with that, I will move forward to the second type of numerical, second type of multi-pressure system. This one is consisting of a two compressor and one evaporator. So it's a two compressor with single evaporator. It is utilizing a flash tank, and the previous one does not have flash tank in it. It had a pressure reducing device in it, pressure reducing valve in it, but no flash tank. But this one has a flash tank, so we have to do energy balance or mass balance across the flash tank. So if we do the mass balance, then M3 is equal to M4. M3 is the mass which is entering into the high stage compression, M4 to the condenser, and M5, so, and from M5 to M6. So M.3, M.4, M.5, M.6, they are the same mass which is rotating here. And M.7, the mass which is coming out of the flash tank, going to the evaporator, M.8, and then from the evaporator, M.1, going to the low stage compressor, M.2. So this is the same mass which is going in all of these three devices, expansion valve, evaporator, and the low stage compressor. So that should be equal. Now enthalpy or energy balance across the intercooler flash tank. So we do an energy balance across this intercooler. And as you are familiar with your thermodynamics study, that the energy transfer mechanism is three, that is heat transfer, work transfer, and mass transfer, energy transfer by heat transfer, by work transfer, and by mass transfer. But in case of the intercooler, there is no work, it's a heat exchanger, no work is required. So the work transfer in and out will be zero. Similarly, because we are not adding any heat to the intercooler and we are considering it to be insulated, so there is no waste of heat either, so there is no heat transfer. So Q in, Q out will be, Q dot in, Q dot out will be zero. So what is left is the mass flowing in, energy coming in because of the mass flowing in, and energy leaving because of the mass flowing out. So that's the balanced equation I have written here. So what is flowing in into this flash tank is this M.2 with the enthalpy value of H2. So M.2, H2 is flowing in. M.6 and H6 is also flowing in. So these are two energy due to the mass flow rate which is coming in, and these are the other two which is leaving. So M.3 is leaving here, M.3H3 plus M.7H7. So M.7H7 leaving here. So that is the energy balance equation across the flash tank. COPR again will be the same formula. Cooling capacity divided by the work required by the compressor. Because we are using two compressors, so we are going to add work required by both of the compressors. And cooling capacity produced by the single evaporator here. So that is H1 minus H8. So that's the COPR value. Okay, now moving on. This is the example problem on this on that system, two compressor, one evaporator, okay, with the intercooler, with the flash tank. So consider a two-stage compression refrigeration system with R134A as the working fluid. The refrigerant leaves the condenser as saturated liquid at 1 megapascal. So the condenser pressure 1 megapascal. And it's throttled to a flash chamber come intercooler. So we are using intercooler flash chamber both operating at 0.3 megapascal. So this is the flash tank pressure, which is 0.3 megapascal. The evaporator has a capacity of 50 kilowatt. The only evaporator I have here is this one. It is 50 kilowatt. And the refrigerant leaves the evaporator as saturated vapor at minus 20 degree centigrade. So this point one is at the saturation line, because it is the exit point of the evaporator, as it says here, at minus 20 degree centigrade. The compression process for both compressor are isentropic. So we are considering isentropic process. Use pH plot for the cycle to determine the mass flow rate of the refrigerant through the low and high pressure compressors, the dryness fraction at entry to the evaporator, and the COP of the refrigerator. Okay, so we again start with finding out the enthalpy values at the saturation points. So first saturation point is this H1.1. So point one is at minus 20 degree centigrade. So I have copied that table here, saturation table for R134, minus 20 degree centigrade. So you look it up, it's 386.55, that's what we copy here, kilojoule per kilogram. The second saturation point is this point three, H3, which is at 0.3 megapascal. So 0.3 is not there, not in the table. What we have is 0.2 and 0.29 and 0.31. So we have to interpolate between these two. So it's 398.60 and 399.77. So when you interpolate it, you will get about approximately 399.00 kilojoule per kilogram. Now H5 is Hg at 1 megapascal. So for Hg at 1 megapascal, so 1 megapascal in saturation table is not there, exactly 1 megapascal, but we have 0.96 and 1.01, and the value is 253 and 256.41. So interpolate between these two values, you should be getting it 255.48 kilojoule per kilogram. Okay, and then H7 is the saturated vapor and saturated liquid HF at this 0.3 megapascal. Again, for this also we have to do an interpolation. It is between 200 and 202, 0.3 megapascal, 0.29 and 0.31. So HF value is 200, 0.29 and 202.69 for 0.31. So if you interpolate, you should be getting about 200.89. So these are straightforward from the table, these values. Now H6 is equal to H5, so you know that, and H7 is equal to H8, so those are already known. What is not known is these superheated region, 0.2 and 0.4. How to find that? You can either interpolate the superheated table or you have to use the chart. Here it says use the pH plot of the cycle to determine. So I will show you both how to do with the interpolation and how to do with the chart. Q.L, the only evaporator here, H1 and H8 we find out, so we can find out what is M.1. So M.1 is 0.2693 kilogram per second. And H6, we are also required to find out what is in the first one, the mass flow rate of the refrigerant through the low and high compressor. So we have to find the mass flow rate. That's why we need to find out what is the X value, the quality at 0.6. So the quality at 0.6 will be H6 is equal to H7 plus X6 times H3 minus H7. All these enthalpy values we already found out. So we can determine what is x6. So x6 is 0.2756. Okay. Now the mass balance equation is that m dot 7 is equal to m dot 5 minus what is gone to the flash tank, which is m dot 5 times x6. Okay, so m dot 7 m dot 8 m dot 1, they are same. m dot 5 m dot 4 and m dot 3 4 5 and 3, they are the same here, you know, from the high pressure compressor. So if I substitute the values here, I will get m dot 5 as 0.3718. so m dot 1 is the mass which is circulating in the low pressure compressor, and m dot 5 is the mass which is circulating in the high pressure compressor. So that's one of the requirements, the mass flow rates of the refrigerant through the low and high pressure compressor. So we found out both of them. So moving on to find out H8. Question number 2, it says the dryness fraction at the entry to the evaporator, this point. We need to find out what is this point. So this H8 will be equal to, because it is in the mixture region, it will be equal to HF at this pressure, which is minus 20 degree centigrade at this temperature or at this pressure, plus X8 times HG minus HF. HG of this point and HF of this point at that pressure. So if we take the value at minus 20 degree centigrade, we take HF and HG from here, so 386.55 and 173.64, if we take these values, take the difference, multiply it with the X8 and HF. H8 is already known, all these values are coming from the table except the X8. So the quality of the vapor entering the evaporator is 0.128 is the quality. Instead of, if we just expanded from 5, the quality would have been right here, but because we have used the flash tank, so the quality is at this point here. So it's a low quality, but it has more moisture in it, less gas or moisture in it, which is good for the refrigerating system. COPR will be the cooling capacity divided by the two compressor work. We already found out all these enthalpy values, and QL we already know it. It has been given as 50 kilowatt. So using that, we can figure out that the COPR is 3.71, which is about right. Okay, so that is it. This is by simply doing it. Did I miss something? I think I missed H2 and H4. Yeah, how to figure out H2 and H4. So H2 and H4, as I said, they are both in the superheated region. Okay, so there is two ways that we can do it: either interpolate the superheated table or use the chart. So for that, H2, if you look up, the first one is H2 is at the constant entropy line from point 1. So we have to determine the entropy of point 1, then we draw the line and see where it crosses 0.3 megapascal. So it is this one. 0.3 megapascal is not in the table. We have 0.2 megapascal and we have 0.4 megapascal. So we are going to interpolate between these two. 390 double interpolation will be required. First, find out what is the enthalpy value at 0.3 by interpolating this one. At the given entropy, the entropy we will figure out entropy point of point H1 is minus 20 degrees centigrade. Minus 20 entropy is 1.74. So using this 1.74, draw the line. Using that 1.74, 1.72, and 1.73. So between these two, we have to interpolate, and we find out what is the and the pressure between the point. First, find out what is the value at point 3 pressure, and then interpolate again to find out at point 3 and 1.74. This entropy value 1.74, what is the H2 value? Okay, for H2 we have to go through double interpolation. And for H4, H4 is 1 megapascal. So if we can find out what is the entropy of point 3, then draw that line, okay, or get the value of entropy for point 3. Point 3 is point 3. Point 3 here is at 0.3 megapascal. So 0.3 megapascal is not in the table, but 0.2 and 0.29 and 0.31 is in the table. So interpreting these two and interpreting this entropy value, we will give us the entropy S3 at this point. And then we have to figure out what is this using this entropy and using 1 megapascal superheated table, interpolate and find out what is the H2 value here. So here we have 1 megapascal, and the entropy value that you will get by interpolating these two, 1.72 and 1.76, maybe 1.73. Okay. So at 1.73, if you interpolate the enthalpy, find out the enthalpy here, so you get 419 something. So what I have taken is 424 if I go through the interpolation. Okay, and so that's how we are going to interpolate, and we get the H2 and H4 values of 424 and 401. But if we use the table, if you use the chart, sorry, so the pressure lines are 1 megapascal was the condenser pressure line right here, the dark brown one, and this is the flash tank pressure of 0.3, this is 0.2 megapascal, this is 0.4 megapascal, 0.3 somewhere here, okay? And then we have the evaporator pressure line of, what was the evaporator, at minus 20 degrees centigrade right here. So I draw a line at minus 20 degrees centigrade, horizontal line. So that is the evaporator pressure line. Now we have to draw the constant entropy lines, okay? And then wherever that constant entropy line will cross the flash tank pressure line, that will be our H2 value. And wherever the constant entropy line will cross our condenser pressure line, that will give us the vertical line from that cross section point, will give us the value for H4. So the entropy values, because this point 1 and point 3, they are known that they are on the saturation line. So when I draw this line, let's start with the point 1. Okay, when I draw this point 1 line, horizontal line at minus 20 degrees centigrade, so it crosses the saturation line right at point here. So I have to read this entropy value and draw this red line, which is now the constant entropy line, and it is between 1.7 and 1.8. So it is like approximately at the center of the two. So 1.75 may be the entropy line, this red one, which is going from here. And it is crossing the flash tank line right here at this point. So from here, I draw a straight vertical line, so I get this one. So this value is between 400 and 450, okay? So it is more close to 400. You have to make equal division between this line from 400 to 450, and then divide this 50 value among the equal lines, you know, maybe 5 lines to 10 each, so then it will become 400 and hold on one second, it will be like 4, more close to 400, so H2 will be something like 401, 402. Okay. Similarly, H4, because H3 we know that it is saturated, in the question it is given, it is at the saturation point, saturation line, vapor saturation line. So H4 is, H3 is right here, point 3 is right here. So we read what is the entropy value and draw the constant entropy line from point 3 going towards the condenser pressure, the green line, green one. So as I draw that line, it is again between 1.7 and 1.8 entropy value, but it is more close to 1.7. Okay, so as we draw this line, you know, trying my best to you know, keep it constant with reference to these two values, 1.7 and 1.8. So it crosses the horizontal line at this point. Okay, the green line is crossing the dark brown line at this point. So draw this vertical green line from here. So again, it is between 400 and 450, but this time it is right about, you know, in the center of the two. So it is more close to like 425 value. So the value I have taken is 424.07. So that's how you can find out H2 and H4. H2 and H4 you need it for compressor work. Okay. So Q dot L divided by compressor 1 work plus compressor 2 work, W dot C2. So substitute the values because we have calculated all the enthalpies already. And QL is already given, 50 kilowatt. So calculating it, you will get your answer as COPR of 3.71. So I hope this is clear and you can do it by yourself. Please do practice by yourself and you learn how to use this chart and how to read the values off of it. And if there is any difficulty, you can again ask me during the live session, and I hope this will be okay, but it does need practice. You have to practice to get right value. So once you start doing it by yourself and practice, I have also provided you the list of suggested problems, so do those problems, so that will also help you to understand and become good and efficient in finding out the right values, right enthalpy values. I thank you very much again. So inshallah we'll meet again in the next week. This will be the third lecture of this week. So I will stop here and then we'll start again for the next week. Thank you.